It's that time of year again. That time of year when you begin to think about buying gifts for loved ones. That time when you expand and or blow your budget. That time when you think about getting a little something extra for yourself. Though the tablet almost took over the laptop market at one point, people eventually realized doing some things on a tablet sucks. And the return to the laptop began. If you're like me, you probably have a laptop old enough to start pondering its replacement, but still good enough it's not a necessary purchase. So what can we do? We can upgrade it.
Welcome to the channel. This is Technoscope.
Years ago, the way you sped up a computer was to give the PC more RAM. This was because as your PC ran, it didn't have enough memory to process the things you were attempting to do, and things in memory were written to the hard drive as new data was loaded to be processed in a process called paging. These days, computers typically have at least 4 gigabytes of RAM, meaning you don't run into paging nearly as much unless you're gaming or running productivity apps. But as it turns out, the thing that determines an overwhelming majority of the speed of a PC these days is the drive that stores your data and the operating system, i.e. Windows. As a side note, while the CPU is upgradable on many laptops, it's not easy to do and most people would never attempt such a task, but it is possible on some laptops and can also speed up your machine if done. So the plan is to upgrade the main two things that are easily upgradable on a laptop, the memory and the storage. For the memory or RAM, I will be installing the machine's maximum amount, 8 GB of Corsair Vengeance DDR3. The speed of the RAM isn't as important as this computer could never fully take advantage of it, but this RAM is clocked at 1600 MHz or 1.6 GHz. Be sure to check the specs of your machine to make sure your computer will support the amount of RAM you are installing. I know from experience your machine may report the full amount installed, but will only use the amount supported while giving you strange errors as it hits the support barrier. The difficulty of installing RAM on your laptop will vary from extremely easy to impossible. This is one thing you will definitely want to research before attempting to tackle. Your PC may run DDR2, 3, or 4, and some PCs are easy to upgrade while some cannot be upgraded at all. Some PCs only require the removal of a panel or door on the bottom of the machine with one or two screws. In the case of my laptop, one RAM stick is on the bottom and one is on the top. This means to replace one stick of RAM, I need to remove the keyboard as well. For the storage, we will be replacing the slow 320GB hard disk drive with a very fast 500GB Samsung Evo solid state drive. In the end, this laptop should work like a brand new machine. Upgrading the hard drive will be far easier. Luckily, it's only a matter of removing the hard drive door, removing the old drive, changing the tray, and inserting the new drive. You have two options when it comes to doing a boot drive upgrade. A, you can use the software that comes with the drive prior to doing the physical upgrade, a scenario in which your data will be cloned and copied to the new drive. Or B, you can do a clean installation on the new drive. If you're a novice, I strongly recommend cloning the drive, but if you're a power or advanced user like me, you may want to do a clean install. There are many reasons for wanting to do a clean install, and in my opinion, it's just better if you have the proper software and drivers available. Also, if you're doing the Windows 10 free upgrade, make sure you perform the upgrade and your copy of Windows 10 is activated prior to doing this upgrade. Make sure your upgrade license is tied to your Microsoft login account to save yourself trouble during reinstallation. Failing to do so may mean the need to do two or more Windows installs or the need to purchase a new copy of Windows. I should make a note that my laptop only has SATA 2, which has a bandwidth limit of 3 gigabits per second, whereas the SSD has a SATA 3 interface, which would normally support up to 6 gigabits per second. This means at best, I will only get half the speed this drive is capable of. That sucks in a way, but half the drive's maximum speed is still much faster than the drive being replaced. Here are the numbers. While the memory didn't really make much of an impact on the speed of the computer, adding the extra RAM means much more legroom for apps like Photoshop and for use with the virtual machines. However, adding the SSD made a world of difference. The computer boots much faster now. It can now boot or go in or out of hibernation in a matter of seconds, and load times of software has decreased dramatically, making the machine feel like it's much more powerful than it actually is at times. One unforeseen benefit is the longer battery life. This can vary, but you should see a small increase of some type as there's no longer a parasitic spinning disk eating power. As long as I'm not taxing the processor much, I've seen an average increase of about 2 extra hours of battery life. So is it all worth it? If you're in no hurry to buy a new computer, it is most definitely worth it. The return in price per performance is far greater in this upgrade than anything you can get from a new machine at the store. Save yourself that money and use it on other purchases you need to make. I hope you enjoyed this video. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel and hit the bell to make sure you get our notifications. Thumbs up if you like this video. My name is Elemento, and this is Technoscope.
Technoscope is a Twisted Curve production.